We are given the state of stress in a body that is uniform, and it is given by these six stress values. So now what we need to do is we need to find the three components of stress on the traction vector for the surface A, B, C, D, so essentially this surface right here. And then what we also have to do after that is find the normal component, sigma sub n, of the stress vector, or essentially of that traction vector. So now what we can start out by doing is we can focus on this side face here in the xy plane. Because notice if we were to have some sort of traction vector coming off the side here, it would only be in the x and y directions. So let's look at this face here and draw that in our xy plane. So essentially have a 45 degree angle. This will be a right angle. And then we'll shade it green just to mimic essentially both faces. So this face right here is going to be this green face in our triangle. So now coming off of this, we'll have a normal vector that will be perpendicular to this face. Now let me extend that a little bit more so we can essentially draw our subcomponents of this normal vector. So now this will be n, and then this piece will be n sub x and n sub y. Will essentially be the x and y components of the normal vector. And now we can actually calculate what these will be, because n sub x is going to be equal to cosine of 45 degrees times n. Well, here, since n is a normal vector, it is essentially going to have the magnitude of 1. So we can actually get rid of n, because that's just equal to 1. So we'll write this equal to 1. So that makes our lives a little bit easier. So then we can write this as 1 divided by radical 2 for nx. And now for ny, it's going to be the same thing. So we'll have sine of 45 degrees, and that'll be equivalent as well to 1 divided by radical 2. So now we actually have our normal vector, not the one for the traction vector per se, but at least for that surface face. So what we can do is we can write out Cauchy's equation, which is going to be the traction vector, which consists in this case of a three-dimensional traction vector. So we're going to have tx, ty, and tz, essentially the traction components and the three dimensions of our face. But now, just a sneak peek, since we said that we're only writing our normal vector and the x and the y directions, not in the z direction, you can anticipate that t sub z, or the z component of our traction vector, will actually be 0, because there is no z component. We're simply just in that x, y plane. So now the next thing that we can do is we can then draw out what the essentially stress field will be. And we'll follow this format up here, because this is Cauchy's full equation, where we have the traction vector, we have the stress field, and then we have the normal vector. So we're essentially taking these values off to the side and plugging those into our stress field. So sigma x from before, we have 4, and then tau xy is going to be 2, and then it looks like tau xz is going to be 0, and then this is actually mirrored, so we'll have 2, because tau of xy is equal to tau of yx due to symmetry. So essentially this matrix is going to be symmetric about the diagonal. But anyways, sigma y we have as 3, and then we're given 0 for that value, 0, 0, and then sigma z is going to be 0. So we can work with that. Now for the normal vector, oh, almost forgot units, we'll have megapascals. Can't forget units. But then for the normal vector, so we'll take the nx component, you see, because we'll have nx, ny, and then nz. So in the x direction, we have 1 divided by radical 2, same thing in the y direction. And then here, we have no z component, right? Because we're still in that xy plane. So I'll actually say 0 for our n sub z component. So now what we can do is we can write out that our traction vector, tx, ty, tz, is going to be equal to, so I'll pull the 1 over radical 2 out, and then we're essentially just doing matrix multiplication. So we'll have 6 for our first entry, essentially multiplying these two together. We'll have 0. And then same thing for the other rows. And then we'll get 5. And then we'll get 0. And then we also have units. So we can't forget those. So this is essentially our traction vector, or this is essentially the stress components essentially experienced on this face ABCD. Now, in order to find the the normal component sigma sub n of the stress field on that face, essentially all we have to do is we can say that sigma sub n is going to be equal to our traction vector dotted with the normal vector. So pretty much what we can do is we can pull out the 1 divided by radical 2, because we'll have that in our normal vector as well as our traction vector, and then we can essentially just multiply the two vectors. So we'll have 650 for our traction vector, and then we'll have 1 over radical 2. So we're essentially taking this normal vector from before, and then we're multiplying. So we'll have 1, 1, 0, and we'll just multiply across. So essentially we'll have 6 times 1 plus 5 times, or 1, so that'll be 11, and we'll divide by radical 2 squared, which is going to be 2 megapascals. So we get a sigma n of 5.5 megapascals.